Jeez Louise.
Jeez Louise.
He's so fast.
Oh, oh my god. Damn.
Oh!
Oh! Get there.
Oh, go! Oh.
That's a tip.
Oh,
oh.
There
we go.
Oh. There it is.
Yeah, one more.
All right.
How hard
Sriracha is struggling with you. Nice. Oh, I tell you, being on the end is tough.
About Braden, we were bunkmates in Afghanistan. One night, I come back from guard. Tanner looks like he's fucking fumbling around on the top bunk. I'm like, hey, man, wake the fuck up. I go to turn on the light. He's right there. I go turn on, I'm looking at him. I'm like, wake the fuck up, Tanner. As soon as I turn on the light, his fucking asshole is like right in my face right here. I'm like, god damn, fucking smelt like shit. That's my funny story.
All right, who's next?
I'll go, I guess. All right. I remember whenever we got my second chief, Herrera, me and Braden used to fuck around with him in the field, and we used to go shit, like, right underneath the net in the truck, like, right underneath the truck every time. Like, he would always tell us not to, and we would, like, go shit underneath the tire. But one time, we shit underneath the tire, and we had to leave, like, really fast, and we ran the shit over, and we get to the next area that we emplaced, and we got out of the truck, and it smelled like shit the whole time there, and we realized it was a shit all over the tire. So, yeah, that's all. Yeah, all right. Here we go.
I'm still thinking of mine.
All right, who's next?
I'm not going to throw it.
Frosty tips.
All right. Let's see. I think it was about 2019. We were just coming back from deployment. We had a detail, and it was me and Tanner, and we both had to take a shit at the same time. Once we got back, I was like, yo, man, I'm going to run out for about 5 minutes and I'll be back for detail. He's like, all right, that's fine. And then I go into the restroom. I pull my pants down, fucking shitting for about 5-6 minutes. And he walks in. I'm like, dude, what the fuck are you doing? He's like, yo, what the fuck do you mean? Like, we're going to shit together and we're going to be memorable forever. I was like, all right, man. Sounds good to me.
Next.
So they can be. A little bit vile.
So I remember middle of the night in Afghanistan at TB Gambari. I wake up because there's a rocking on the other side of the wall where Tanner stayed, and I look up and there's this hand going towards some Jergens. There's two quick pumps, the hand disappears again.
That's it.
That was that. Alright, should I start going?
Yep.
Alright, so there's a lot of funny memories, but one I can remember right now is, you know, so on deployment, we always would get into it and start arguing because he would rip ass and I have a really weak stomach. Oh. So we would always fight about it. And I remember one time, I think I broke a coffee pot. Like, we started arguing about it because he ripped ass and he started laughing and I was pissed. And we started going at it and I like broke a coffee pot over him. So later on, he's telling me, he's like, I'm going to get you back, Siraj. You know what Fremunda cheese is? And at the time, I'm like, no, what is that? And I'm telling him, like, you're not going to do anything. And he's like, all right, you're going to get you from under cheese. You don't like smells, huh? Still confused. I'm like, I don't know what that is. All right. It's like a couple days later, I'm sleeping in my bunk. And I'm waking up to somebody there, and I hear giggling. Like, somebody's giggling. And I'm like, what? And I was like, as I'm opening my eyes, I see a hand, like, coming out of pants. And just like two fingers come up to my nose, and I open it up, and it's Tanner standing there, and he got me with Fremunda cheese. So.
Corey, you got a funny one?
Not right at the moment.
No.
You
ever think of one?
I'm like over 2 years. I mean. And
you gotta get the mic, man.
Shooting and fun.
Yeah, I remember when we first got to Carson, we would go to Arizona. Yes. We're both Arizona natives. And I don't know if you know this, but Braden is the most impatient person when it comes to road trips. So I would obviously take forever and piss him off. And I remember one time we were taking my cruise down to Phoenix and the handle broke. And we were just driving without a handle for 12 hours. And I remember he was very mad at me, and that's one of the best memories I have with Braden.
Anybody else? I don't have like a buttonhole story. I don't have one. I can say something nice about him.
That's a good one.
Hey,
we
have
Hey, Bray, I've only known you for 2 years now, but you've been a great guy. We both have life events that we relate to, and, you know, whenever I get down, I call you, and just appreciate you being a great guy, great friend.
Oh, it's already on.
Yeah, you don't have to push it, just hold it.
Okay,
okay, go.
Hi. I'm Haley, and my funny story about Val is almost every single time we're on the highway together, we almost die. And I don't know why, but one time we were trying to get off of the highway, and a motorcycle cut in front of us, and I had to slam on brakes, and he got off of his bike, and he turned around, like, was walking to my car, and he was like, sorry, 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 sorry. And it was just, it was hilarious. I don't know. Yeah, that's it.
Hey, Bray. Hey, Val. Yeah, it was a great wedding. We had a great time. It was an honor to be a groomsman. I'm out here with Tammy and Chuck. We're having a great time. Great wedding. Thank you.
Oh. Hey, Braden, and hey, Val. Congratulations to both of you. I wish you many years of happiness. As God is your center, I know you'll do well and go far. Love each other, take care of each other, and God bless you. Congratulations.
Bray and Val, thank you for inviting me to your wedding. You're beginning a journey which will have ups and downs, but it will be something that you all will grow stronger by the day. Thank you again for inviting me, and congratulations and the best to both of you as you start this journey.
Hi, you guys. Your vows were so beautiful today, and I hope that you have the most amazing life together.
Okay. Hi, Valerie and Brandon. It was so nice meeting you today. Valerie, your dress is phenomenal, and you guys make just such a perfect couple. I'm so proud of you. Yeah.
Yep. Hi, guys. Just met Braden today, but he seems like an awesome guy. Happy marriage. Valerie, good luck to you, too. Cousin over here, so just have a good marriage.
Hi, guys. I want to wish you a great marriage. I know you guys very well, but I just want to say you guys are amazing together, and I'm so happy to be here today.
So, I just want to wish y'all a great and happy marriage. I hope that your marriage is filled with blessings. Tanner, I just met your dad today. I'm going to tell you right now, he's a great man. And just like I was saying before, I hope I raise my son to be a half a man that you become. And on top of that, one thing about you, Tanner, that stood out to me, you never let your emotions dictate your decisions in life. And that, to me, like, it spoke volumes. So I just want to say I admire that about you. I hope to adopt that from you. And hey, happy wishes to your marriage.
You want to say anything funny about him?
Anything funny about him? No, I'm not gonna do that. Till that. His butter poop. I wouldn't say it's butter poop, but hey, Saturdays is for the boys.
Hey, Braden and Valerie, this is Chad. I'm here with Natalie. She's been bragging about you for years, ever since I met her. Couldn't stop hearing about Valerie. It's nice to have a face to a name. I'm really happy for you guys, and I'm excited to get to know you all better.
Great. Hey, Valerie and Braden, I'm super excited to be here at your wedding, and I'm excited for the next years to come for you both. And to grow closer together as friends and see your relationship grow and blossom into wonderful things.
Hey guys, thanks for having us, and I wish you guys nothing but the best, and I can't wait to see you guys have babies. Love y'all.
Hey guys, this is Maria's husband. Congratulations, and
hope you a happy marriage.
He forgot Amelia.
Amelia, you want to say something?
Hey, Valerie and Braden, this is Phil. What a beautiful ceremony. Beautiful words that go with it. Thank you for inviting us. This has just been so beautiful of a day. And I know that God has great plans for you. And I look forward to sharing that future with you guys.
Am I supposed to push the button? Oh, hi, this is Kate. You know who this is. This is Kate. Thank you for inviting us to the ceremony. It is a great celebration of your love. And we're really excited to see, I guess there's babies coming eventually, but that's just a rumor. But anyway, the best of everything in your life together. You've gone through some difficulties, but now is the time to celebrate and enjoy life together. Thank you.
Can I tell my favorite memory? Okay. My favorite memory is this one time my husband told Valerie, do not give Sylvia weed, and she did, and then I couldn't walk, and we cleaned the floors. It was a good time. The end. Next, you're up next, Haley.
I'll go.
No, it's your arms table.
Can we do it together?
No, you just hold it.
Yeah, let's do it together.
Yeah. Well, I could have done mine with my husband.
Keep going right here.
Are you going to go first?
I'll go first. Hey, Braden and Valerie. this is Daniel. You're watching a video, but I love you a lot, and I hope you guys have a great time together. I'm just looking at y'all right now, and you look amazing. Here's Haley.
Hi, I love you guys so much. I'm so glad that I was able to meet both of you, and I know that y'all will have a long and happy life together. Love you guys. Okay.
Oh, yeah, you're next.
You gotta
go.
Get a speech
on
like them.
You guys gotta go together. Here. My favorite, lower right here.
Attention to detail.
Attention to detail. I'm a little retarded. Hey, Tanner, my favorite memory about you is when your wife was going through that, her illness, and you came up to me and told me you needed time off, and I let you take about that 9 months to a year off work. Never once bothered you. I would do that again in a heartbeat because I love you, man. You're one of my best friends. Whenever you need something, reach out to me, man. I'll always be there for you.
Val, I absolutely adore you. We've had so many good memories together. We're so thankful for you guys and so thankful for all the memories and everything. We love you guys so much, and we look forward to many more memories together. Cheers to your day. Who wants it? Okay, go.
Thanks.
Keep it low, keep it low.
Well, Braden, it's been a long run, man. Last 4 years have been the greatest. Having you as a friend has been God blessing, and you and Valerie are definitely a big part of my life, especially whenever you were gone and out of the barracks. Like, I can see that 100%, bro, like, we are family, and regardless of any situation or whatever, anything that'll bring us together, that I will 100% always call you family. And then thank you for being there for me in my lowest times. And I know my low times were kind of a little bit too tough and a little bit too much. But hey, man, if there's anybody I can rely on in this world, it's definitely you. I love you, man. I love you and Val. And I cannot wait to see you pretty soon at my wedding. Hopefully pretty, really soon. And thank you, bro, for being there for me since day one. I love you bunches, bro, and I will always love you as a brother. Man, that's pretty much it. So have a great rest of your wedding, and yeah, we'll see each other again really soon.
Hello. Hey, just wanted to say great wedding, so happy for y'all. Can't wait to see more to come from y'all's future. Love y'all so much.
Valerie, Braden. Oh, Valerie, Braden. Just want to say you guys have a bright future ahead of you, a bright, long future. I knew from the day Tanner met you back in December. I remember he told all of us he met you. I knew y'all were going to get married. And I'm just glad to be here supporting y'all and a part of this. And I just want to say, you know you mean a lot to me when I've been 1 year sober but I'm having drinks. I'm having drinks for your wedding. So you know.
You're on. Say something nice to Braden and Val.
Braden and Val. Braden, known you for, what is it, about a month and a half now, 2 months. Ever since I met you, you've been a good friend, caring, told a lot of stories, pretty funny dude. Just want to say congratulations. Hope you guys stay healthy. Yeah, that's all I got. All right,
you, your turn.
Good?
Yep, right. We're good.
What's up, Braden? I haven't known you for the longest, but the time I've been working with you, you're pretty funny. You're also very smart. The times we've talked, you're pretty smart, and yeah, to you.
Say something about his farts if you want.
Oh, yeah. You do be finding a lot on the jobs. I'll give you that. I'd be walking around. He farts. Well, I already know it's Braden. I don't even have to.
Yeah.
All right.
You know, but this is just for them. This isn't for family.
Yeah, yeah. But yeah. have a happy and healthy marriage to you and Val, and congratulations.
Right, thank you.
Yeah.
All right, Braden, you are one of the best work coworkers I've ever had, bro. You're hella funny. This is the best wedding I've ever been to, bro. For real, I'm pretty drunk right now, but congrats, brother. And okay, I love you. Bye.
Hi, my name's Uncle Mike. Braden, to me, I've known him since he was before he was born, and I watched him grow into a fine young gentleman. And I'd have to say, me and his father talked about some crazy times where he was talking about he was going to go to California, live in his vehicle, and be a superstar. The moment his dad told me that he was joining the military, it was the happiest day of my life. He has grown into the best young man I've ever known in my life. I'm very proud of him, and I love him with all my heart, just like I love his dad and I love his mom, Kelly Jo. And that's all I gotta say.
Hey, Valerie, we love you. And yeah, she's videoing.
Oh, happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Happy wedding!
You gotta get closer to your mom.
Happy wedding!
We're so glad I'm glad that I'm a part of your family and you're a part of our family, and we're just one big happy family. We always will be. Love you both.
Yeah.
I hope you're not constipated anymore.
All right, we're recording.
Okay.
This is from your Uncle Angela, Uncle Philip with Aunt Angela. Pray together every night. Pray and be willing to be transparent, vulnerable, and be the warrior, because now Satan's coming to get you.
Very good. Braden, we're very proud of you and we love you very much. And you could not have picked a better fit for a wife. Y'all are just a perfect match and we love you both very much. And your mom would be very proud of you tonight. We love you.
Braden.
You don't have to hold it up.
From the bottom of my heart, I love you so much you will never ever in your life understand. I love you through the good times, the bad times. I love you not because you're my grandson, but because of who you are and who you've made yourself to be. And the perfect partner for the rest of your life. Walk with God, my son. Walk with God. Gran loves you. Bye-bye.
All right, passing on to Shelly.
Okay, Braden, Alec, and Val, I'm so happy for both of you. Always be nice to each other, be kind to each other, love each other, forgive each other, and don't forget to laugh.
I love this hairdo.
Okay, what are we doing?
She says, okay.
Okay, in a minute. Yeah. Huh?
Something nice.
Okay.
Are you also videoing?
Oh. You want to do it together or separately?
I'm doing it separately.
When do I go?
Just talk.
Oh, okay.
We would fail.
Braden, that. Kind of awkward.
Hold it right here.
Okay.
Just talk.
Braden, Alec, I love you so much, and I wish you and Val all the best. So so happy we could come see you in person for this beautiful day. We wish you love and happiness for all of your days.
Do I push anything?
Nope.
Hi, this is Keldon, your cousin. I love you very much. We are synced souls, and I can't wait to party with you and dance with you tonight on your wedding night. I love you and Val. She's perfect for you. You guys are like gloves. You're made for each other. I love you.
You got way better equipment now.
Okay, stand up. Okay. Do we have to do any push anything? Oh, okay.
B-Boy, we're so proud of y'all. We want y'all to come down to Texas and hang out with us sometime.
Absolutely.
Come to Cycleland. I'll throw you in that black water again. Love you, buddy.
We love you. We hope that your marriage lasts as long as our 30 years. It's hard. It's tough, but it's worth it. So we
very
love
worth
you.
It.
And thank you for inviting us here. It's a blessing to be here.
Love you, buddy.
So, for occasions like this, it's very common for the best man to give a speech. So for those of you who don't know me, my name is Nayat. A few of you know me as Siraj. I am Braden's best man. So in the military, we always speak of all kinds of missions. As best man today, I have tried to get through my duties without causing serious injury to anyone. By the end of this speech, I'll let you decide if we can finally call my mission complete. For Braden and Valerie, though, your mission in life has truly just begun. To say Braden is my best friend would be an understatement. A more appropriate word would be my brother. The amount of times this man has pulled me out of life's quicksand is almost embarrassing to count. I take a lot of pride in being able to stand next to him today. When Braden first brought up Valerie, I knew that she was the woman he would end up marrying. Even if it hadn't dawned on him quite yet, it was obvious to everyone around just how smitten he was with her. They talk about a bride's glow, but this man was shining since the moment he met Valerie. He changed for the better without realizing it, and we all could see it. He couldn't stop talking about her. We would go out with the boys, and her name would be brought up every 2 minutes. So when he came to tell me that he would be proposing, my only response was, well, it's about time. There's something special about these two. They go together without forcing it. They love each other without fighting it. She was the one from the very beginning. And we're all so happy to be able to take part in your big day. Braden and I first met while serving in the Army, and after a lot of close times together, we eventually became as close as brothers. We had many things in common, but we were very different kinds of soldiers. For instance, he's always been the rebellious type and never liked the higher ranks telling him what to do. Whenever a superior gave a command, he would always speak his mind and do it his way instead, because he thought his way worked better. Because of all that experience and not following orders, he should make a pretty good husband. I went on my very first tour of duty to Afghanistan with Braden. We spent the better part of a year together over there. We came back and we never left each other's sides. Although our friendship doesn't extend back to when we were kids, military time is unique. 5 years of camaraderie during active service, depending on one another for support, that translates into a lifelong friendship in civilian terms. When I was thinking of this speech, there was a lot of memories that came to mind, and I couldn't pick just one. But I remember, you know, there was memories like pulling guard in the guard tower and deployment and talking about life for hours and hours on end. But the one memory that is very fond in my mind was the night after we got done, we were on this mission shooting, and we were sitting on this giant pile of dirt. And when you looked up into the distance, you could see the Apaches and fighter jets flying over us. The sun was setting down behind the mountains. And you could have sworn it was a scene from a movie. And it, you know, in the background, we had the song, "The Night We Met" by Lord Huron playing while bombs are dropping in the background. It really encompasses the bond we have. You helped make deployment suck a little less and reminded me of all the reasons to keep fighting. And I know I've never thanked you for that until now, but that's all behind us. And now I can say, I'll never forget the look on your face when you got married. Thank you for going out of your way to include me in your life, for always being someone I can count on. It's safe to say Braden is the most thoughtful and dedicated person I have ever had the pleasure to call my friend. I'm so glad that he found someone that mirrors his amazing personality. I know for sure that Valerie and Braden have a long and bright future ahead of them.
I fucking love you, man. God damn, dude.
I just want to say, this is the most wholesome couple that I know. Especially Valerie. She's such a good friend to everyone around her. Braden is such a gentleman to not only Valerie, but all of her friends.
Yes.
And I just want to say that I'm so happy that I got to experience this day with you as your bridesmaid.
He's like, oh yeah.
I'm giving her.
I did not have anything prepared at all. So I just wanted to say that I love both of you guys so much. You, Braden, have been a tremendous friend to my husband, and you helped him through a lot of hard times.
Woo!
Yeah. Woo! and when I moved here to Colorado, I knew nobody but my husband, as that usually, you know, happens in the military. And when I met Tanner and Val, I felt so warm, you know, like they made me feel welcome, and I appreciated that. And I'm so happy that I could be a part of your big day, and I love you guys so much.
Love you.
I don't know. Ooh. I'm gonna just hold this guy over here. Hi. So I first met Val when we were really young. No, I'm just playing. She's my sister. She is also so much more than that. She is not only my sister, she is my best friend, my co-conspirator, co-mayor of a multitude of Barbie and Bratz towns that could not have been well planned at all. I swear. And she has also been one of the biggest support systems I can say I'm happy to have. She has been through so much, and she will still give all of the love in her heart to people who need it. And I see that in her every day, and I also see that in Braden every time I see him interact with Valerie.
Whoa. Walk it off.
All right. Braden. You are a lucky guy, dude. Can I just say, when we were kids, Val would have pages full in her notebooks of all the boys in her class that she thought were cute. And you made the cut, buddy. Oh my gosh. All right, we're gonna close this out. All right, Valerie. Love you, babe. You are one of the most stubborn, fiery people I have ever met. And I love seeing that fire in you, and I love seeing Braden match that fire in you. It's that Aries energy. And I love seeing how fiercely and how loyally you guys love and support each other all the time. And I'm just so proud to call you my family. And I'm so excited to have a brother. I love you guys.
Thank you. It's been a little over 2 years of knowing you, and I can say you have become one of my best friends. The first time I met you, we went up into the mountains, and I was pretty shy to talk to you, and now look at us.
Yeah.
I can't imagine my life without having you as my best friend.
When I first met both of y'all, I noticed the love that y'all share. Since I met y'all, I have admired what you guys have. I cannot thank or repay what you guys have done for me. You have opened your home to me and provided the support that I needed at the time. It's funny looking back at where we first started and how much we have grown together. All our girls' nights, and maybe too much wine, has grown our bond very strong. This is a short speech to fit it in, but I can't go on about our experience, but to sum it up, I thank God for allowing my path to align with yours.
And I'm just up here because she was too shy to come by herself. I've known Bray for about 2 years now, and one of the first people I met when I moved to Colorado, and he's an amazing friend, amazing person. And I lost my mother in the same way he did, so we've grown a good bond through that, and it's really awesome to have such a supportive, good person as a friend. So, congrats to both of you.
I met Brayden in 2016 of October. It all started when we sat down and we were in MEPS about to join the Army, and I'm like, hey man, I'm Craig. And that was the first time I got stuck to Brayden, and since there we went through quite a bit of trials and tribulations. I've been with Brayden in his life for quite a few years. I first met or heard about Valerie through the walls of our barracks room when they'd be on the phone for hours, and then I ended up meeting Val. We ended up traveling to Colorado, and after Bray got back from deployment, and that's when Val and I started to get close. And then I remember I visited for the SJS when she was still in the hospital, and it's just been a great journey through y'all's life, and I'm just so thankful that y'all had me in it, and I'm just so thankful to be here. Jesse.
Tell you this, Brayden and Val have been a perfect example of a excellent couple. And as much of a heartache as Brayden can be sometimes, he can also be a very loving friend. I went through a lot after deployment. We both went through a lot after deployment. And at the time I was single, I didn't have my beautiful wife at the time. But to have him and Val together supporting me through a lot of things that I went through, I cannot say, I cannot express how much I am grateful to have him as a friend, as a brother, no matter how far we are, whether it be 1,000 miles apart or 10,000 miles. I know that he will always be a friend, a brother, and someone I've always wanted to grow up in my life. And I can't stress it enough. He helped me through a lot. A lot of things that I went through in my life. It was very, very hard, you know, for the average person, but I stand here today, and to be a part of his wedding, even though we don't talk every single day or every single night, as him and Val did on the daily, but I am grateful to have him as a friend, as part of my family, and for him to welcome me into his family. And I will always, always cherish the moments we shared on deployment together, because they're unforgettable. So thank you for being, thank you so much, man. Like, you did a lot for me at the time.
Yeah, a lot.
It's hard. And I appreciate you, bro. I really do. Thank you.
But I'm also a friend, not just a friend, but a brother of Brayden's. I've known him for the last 5 years, going on 6, of course through the Army. But I just wanted to set the record straight. Everybody comes up here and say how hard-headed he is. Yes, he is hard-headed. But out of the boys, everyone here, he was always the most level-headed also. He was always the one that when you were going through something, he helped out everybody. when you're going through something, he was always the one to say, hey, calm down, slow down, let's think about this. And most of the time you'll figure out that you were probably in the wrong. But in saying that, I just want to say, I appreciate you, right? The gestures that you make, you, for most people, is going out their way. For you, it's part of your character. And I've always appreciated that about you. I always admired that about you. For y'all that didn't know, I outage all the boys by about 10 years. I joined the Army late, but I'm not gonna stand up here and say that I didn't learn anything from you. Because of you, I've become a better man, a better soldier, a brother, brother, and I love you for that. I just wanna say that.
Damn, bro. Yeah.
I thought I was just going to sing my song, and then I heard that Valerie had a book of boyfriends, or Angelisa. Why didn't I ever hear about this? But Dad is the last to know, every effing time. So, I count on Braden not to keep secrets from me. And no, it's just amazing how this just came together. I don't have to lie either. I am so proud of you guys. What you've done, what you're gonna do. You help bring us back together. You strengthen us. And this is all God. It's all God. He's just got you guys by the heartstrings. You guys are great. You love rock and roll. It's amazing. This is a match for all of us. So I just want to say I really love you guys. Anna really loves you guys. She did not want to come up here. And we'll talk about the book later. So. All right, cool.
Love you, man. Love you, Dad.
Love you.
So for those of you that don't know, I'm Braden's dad. I don't have a prepared speech like Siraj there. So I'm just going to kind of wing it. It seems to work out for me. You know, we've all been to a lot of weddings. People get up here and basically they lie. They lie and they say, oh, I wish these people a long life. And we all know they're not going to make it. And then they lie and they say, these two are meant for each other. They're perfect for each other. Another lie. People all the time at weddings across America stand in front of groups like this and lie about the future of the couple. But I'm happy to say that I don't have to lie. The time. Choked up. What the fuck? So, jeez. The times that they've been together, they've already been through a lot. And already proven their mettle as a couple. I feel stupid. For those of you that don't know, when you get older, you cry easier. Okay? So, 23, I ain't shedding no tears, okay? But, yeah, they've been together through a lot of tough times. Each supporting each other through their difficult time. Braden, with her Steven Johnson syndrome, and also Valerie supporting him with his mother. Just those two little things are huge and sometimes don't even happen to people that have been married for 10 years. So when I stand up here, I say, I don't have to lie. I know that they're going to be in my life Well, until the day I die. And I look forward to it. I have my son and my nuera, which is daughter-in-law in Spanish. And that's it.
Appreciate each and every one of you taking the time out of your day, taking the time out of your weeks, taking the time out of your months, taking the time out of your jobs to make it over here. Man, this is, I'm so fortunate. Everyone in this room is absolutely incredible. To people that have known me, you know, before I've known myself, and to people that I've shed blood with, and to people that I work with, and to, you know, parents of my friends who are incredible people, and parents of my wife's who really are a good judge of her character, because you guys are incredible. One of them, you know, our officiant. What's up? Let me hear it for him. Come on. Y'all were all complimenting him. It's true. He's the best. He's the best. Baby, you gotta say anything?
Oh no, I just let you talk. Right. You know I love you all. I'm ready to party.
Guys, yeah. My wife's ready to party.
Woo!
So let's go. Right? All right.